always thought that I was going to be an author, but I never thought I was going to be a children's book author. And it wasn't until the deaths of Ahmaud Arbery, Breonna Taylor, and George Floyd that I really started to look at where my voice can be heard.
Again, Devale Ellis, you know, you have so many things under your belt right now. I mean, you're a host, co-host of your podcast, you have a former NFL player, you're an actor, and now you're the author of a children's book. So how are you, and how are you balancing all of this?
Well, I'm doing well. And first and foremost, thank you for having me. I'm able to balance because I have a great team. I have a beautiful wife who is my partner in everything I do. So she's able to keep me on track. You know, we always joke that when you have a partnership, you know, you always have the creative, then you always have the person that does all of the administrative work. That's my wife, Khadeen. She makes sure that I'm on point. She's been that way since we've been in college. She always made sure my classes were at the right time. She made sure I got to where I was going to. And we just have a good partnership together. So having her with me and doing life with me has been great. And then my team, of course, making sure that I'm on point. So it's been good. It's been good.
Yeah. I mean, you have to be each other's biggest cheerleaders. And I can definitely see that, both you and Khadeen, and the way you raise your kids. And that kind of leads me into your book, you know. Mm-hmm. You have had such a career already, and now you're adding a children's book author. I have to ask, have you ever, like, even as an NFL player, did you ever think that you were going to be writing a children's book at some point in your life?
No, I didn't, to be honest. I never really thought about, I always thought about being an author. I always wanted to put my words on paper. I love writing. You know, I love writing. I also do scripts. You know, I'm currently working on a couple projects in development. But I always thought that I was going to be an author, but I never thought I was going to be a children's book author. And it wasn't until the deaths of Ahmaud Arbery, Breonna Taylor, and George Floyd that I really started to look at where my voice can be heard. And it was because my son came to me at the time, he was 8, and he said, he asked me a very profound question. He said, "Daddy, why do we have to say Black Lives Matter? Doesn't everyone know that?" Mm-hmm. And I was like, wow, you know, like it's funny that you would think everyone knows that, but people don't know that. And he was like, "Why don't they know that? Like why don't they know that?" And then I started to explain to him the history of America. And that's when I realized that people aren't taught America's true history. For example, they don't know that we came here in 1619. America fought for their freedom from Great Britain in 1776. At that time, Blacks were considered property or 3/5 of a human being. So when the Constitution was rewritten and created, it was created for us to be less than human. So ultimately, Black lives never mattered. Like, we did not matter. And then if you look at history throughout that time, from slavery to Black codes, the Vagrancy Act, convict leasing, redlining, Jim Crow, the war on drugs, mass incarceration, there are things in our Constitution and in our laws that continue to say that Black lives don't matter. And when I wanted to teach my son about racism, I didn't want to teach him hate and bigotry, because that can be daunting for a young man. He can feel like, well, if this is the way the world is, then why should I care? It's always going to be this bad. So I just decided to teach him history and say, this is why we have to say Black Lives Matter, is because this is how Black people have been marginalized and disenfranchised in this country. These are the changes that have happened since slavery. Now we have mass incarceration. So it's slavery by another name, but there have been changes. And if we continue to push forward, we can get mass incarceration out of here, and we can continue to move towards a more equal life. So for me, it was just being able to give my son some hope. Use animation, but also educate him. So when people ask him those questions, "Jackson, why do you say Black Lives Matter?" he can tell them why. And I wanted everyone to know why. So that's why I came up with the book.
Yeah, and it's so much fun. I mean, the Ellis is in the time machine, and I love how you kind of play on the time machine. It kind of reminds me of Back to the Future.
Absolutely.
Right? And I also love how you did it as a family, and you really just kind of showed how, you know, you and Khadeen were in this conversation together, and you were both guiding this with your kids, and you were a team. You were a team. And that's what I think was really just, that struck out to me, because I just love seeing that kind of, I love history, but I love seeing the relationships, that thread that's just kind of continuing throughout the book.
I think it's important to show the relationship, because also in showing Black Lives Matter, you have to talk about Black love. because part of the way they dehumanize us is by saying that we don't love each other. You know, they say Black men don't respect Black women. You know, Black women, they tear down Black men. And that's been the narrative by the people who control the narrative. But now we control our own narrative. So if we can control our own narrative, why not us show love, show us loving each other? So I chose purposefully to include Khadeen as the family aspect of the book. And it wasn't just me and Jackson. It was me, Khadeen, Jackson, Cairo, and Kaz, because it's also about legacy. You know, the generational wealth gap in this country was built on legacy. You know, a lot of white families built their legacy on passing down wealth from generation to generation. And I plan on doing that with my family. As a matter of fact, the second installment of the book is called The Ellises and the Time Machine, What is Generational Wealth? And we're going to take a history lesson on how we have not been able to gain access to wealth. So I have a plan. Hopefully people stick with me and see where we're going. But I really want to do some great things with this book.
Well, and that actually kind of, I was going to ask, like, what's next? Because it almost seems like you can have a series with the book as well.
Yes.
And real quick, I want to ask any tips for Black parents who are trying to navigate these really tough conversations in this climate with little ones?
The tip is to be honest, you know, and that's for any parent, Black, white, Asian, Latin. It's be honest. You know, teach history. I don't know if people have an opportunity to watch the 13th Amendment on Netflix or watch Amend, Will Smith's new documentary, but teach history. I've always been a big student of history. I read a ton of books. But if you can understand where racism is rooted and it's rooted in greed, you can teach your children what racism truly is and also how to dismantle it. Because you understand that it don't matter how many books we write, how many hashtags, how many times we protest, unless legislation is changed for Black and brown people to be considered as human as white people, and we knock down white supremacy, it'll never change. So teach history. If you teach history, you can be honest and you don't have to feel guilty about telling them what have already gone on in America.
I love it. I love it. So my final question is, what's next? I mean, for Devale, the Ellises, I mean, you mentioned the book, and anything on the bucket list that you want to do down the road?
Well, first and foremost, shout out to my beautiful wife, Khadeen. She actually wrote the activity book for the Ellises and the Time Machine, which will be coming out shortly. Her and her entrepreneurial mindset said we have two young kids who can't read yet, but they like doing activities. So it has crossword puzzles and things of that nature and little different word searches so they can start to learn about the same book, but in a different mindset. So shout out to her. That'll be coming out soon. I'm doing the second installment of the book. Season two of Bigger is coming out, and I'm a recurring role on that series as well. So that's coming out on BET Plus. And on my bucket list, one thing I want to do on my bucket list is skydive.
Ooh.
I'm probably going to skydive and I'm going to film it because I'm afraid to death of skydiving. So maybe for my 40th birthday, once the world opens back up, I plan to show people that I'm not afraid, and I just want to do it to show people not to be afraid. So I'm probably going to skydive my 40th birthday.